Welcome to the Master Cars Pro channel. Today we'll talk about the problems and weaknesses of Volvo S80. Few cars make long distance journeys as relaxing as the Volvo S80. The larger engines are all refined and provide a S80 with decent performance, while wind and road noise are nicely suppressed for the comfortable chases, and it really does waft you along as the miles fall away. But the big front wheel drive saloon won't do is encourage you to leave the motorway and take the twisty road. The steering is dull and body control poor. Even the high powered T6 doesn't have a chassis sharp enough to do its performance justice. It's better to sit back, relax, and enjoy the big, comfortable, supportive seats. The dashboard may not be the most exciting, but it's logically laid out with plenty of storage space. Rear passengers have luminous like levels of legroom, and the boot is massive and bigger still once the rear seats are folded. If you can set your badge snobbery aside, your money will go an awful lot further on Volvo S80 than it'll on the equivalent BMW 5 Series or Audi A6. You'll end up with a much better equipped car too. The petrol engines can cover 12,000 miles or go for a year before needing a service, while the diesels are only slightly shorter, the 10,000 mile intervals, which isn't too bad, especially when you consider that Volvo dealers charge less than their BMW and Audi counterparts for servicing. However, independent Volvo experts tend to be slightly more expensive than those who specialize in used BMWs and Audis. As long as you stay away from the Group 32-33 rated T6, insurance costs are reasonable too. Diesel engines are particularly good news. With just the Group 27 rating, the D5's official 44 mpg should put a smile on your face too. But the T6 claimed 25 mpg is less appealing. As a manufacturer, Volvo enjoys a reasonable reputation for reliability with strong showings in recent JD Power customer satisfaction surveys. So it comes as something of a surprise when you click on to www.volvo.gov.uk and find a list of recalls as long as they queue around the block for the next iPhone. There are too many details here, but some deal with major concerns such as possible fuel leaks, suspension failures, and seatbelt anchorage problems. So ensure that your car that the car you're interested in has had all the necessary work done. A Volvo dealer should be able to tell you. Also, beware of diesel engines that are reluctant to start or produce black smoke under hard acceleration. Also, listen out for rattles, which can mean that the exhaust heat shield has worked loose. Although that's not too serious a problem, more worrying are leaking oil coolers and automatic gearboxes. The units are mounted low down and can get damaged by speed bumps. Well, if you are the owner of this car, then please describe the problems that you had to face during the operation of the car. Perhaps it is your feedback that'll help viewers when choosing a car. That's it for today. Thanks everyone for attention. It isn't much work for you to subscribe to the channel. See you soon.